Hey you guys, welcome to my channel, Nursing with Key, where I share a whole bunch of nursing videos, tips, tricks, and advice also from other nursing students in my class to help all of my aspiring nursing students and all of my current nursing students have the smoothest nursing journey. So if you're into all of that kind of stuff, you might want to consider subscribing so that you could be the first person to get a So today's video is going to be a very quick video. I'm just going to show you guys how to draw blood. I took my cardiovascular class a very, very long time ago, so I had a lot of practice with blood draws, and also all the videos that I'm gonna share showing you guys procedures are going to be overlooked by my teachers, so don't worry, I'm not giving you guys any false information or anything. But yeah, I just want to make this video really quick, so let's get right into it.
Okay, so the first thing you want to do is look at your TNP, well, look at your doctor's order to see why you're taking the blood. In case the patient asks you, you want to know, you want to be able to explain it to them. So check your doctor's order, then you're going to come to your patient's room, hand sanitize, and then the second step is to explain the procedure and what you're here for. So the doctor ordered for me to do a blood draw, so I'm going to take some of your blood and we're going to send it off to the lab to get tested so we can try to figure out why you're sick or whatever's happening. And then the third thing is to get consent. So is that okay with you?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so I'm gonna go get my supplies and I'll be back. So I gathered all of my my materials and now I'm in the patient's room. So before I start touching anything, the first thing I'm gonna do is hand sanitize. This is not the hand sanitizer you would have. You would have a hospital, like the big bottles of hand sanitizer, but we don't have it in this lab. So I'm gonna hand sanitize. So I'm just gonna start preparing my stuff. I like to take a piece of my tape and kind of just put it across my gauze like this, so I can just take it and stick it right onto the patient like that. And then you want to take your needle and prep that like this. Put that down. Have my gloves. Here I would have, I think you'd have the patient's name and stuff. All the patient's information would already be on this, but we're in the lab, we're not in the hospital, so we don't got that. And yeah, kidney basin just for your stuff. This I can kind of put it aside, get rid of it. Okay, so now I have everything ready and I'm ready to go. Okay, so now I'm gonna put my tourniquet about 3-4 inches above where I'm going to put my needle. So I'm gonna tie my tourniquet like this, nothing crazy. And I can put on my gloves. Okay, I'm gonna take my alcohol swab, my alcohol pad. I'm not gonna use it on the mannequin, but you would wipe going outwards and then you can kind of get rid of that. All right, so now I'm ready. I'm gonna take my needle, making sure that the bevel is up, because if the bevel is down, you won't get blood. So the bevel has to be up, and also bring this close by. Now, I'm going to insert like this. And then you take your gauze, put it on. Do not apply pressure until the needle is removed. You remove your needle, and then you would throw this in the biohazard.
Also for the vials have different colors. Different colors are for different things. So depending on what you're taking blood for, make sure you take the right color vial as such. And then you send it to the lab.
So guys, I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. Do not forget to like, comment, subscribe, and share. And if you have any suggestions for any videos you would like for me to do not be afraid to leave them down below. I'll see you in my next video.